two random processes, x of t and y of t, are defined by x of t is equal to a cos omega naught t plus b sine, and y of t is equal to a sine omega naught t minus b cos omega naught. So these are the two different random processes where omega naught is a real constant a and b are uncorrelated random variables. A and B are uncorrelated random variables with zero mean. That is, the mean of expectation of A is zero, expectation of B is also zero, and both are uncorrelated. If both the random variables are uncorrelated, then covariance is equal to zero. That is, the covariance of A B is equal to zero. So you should be very careful. In some cases, we are letting that A as the constant. Okay, in some cases we are letting A as variable. So you must be very careful. Here A, B are both random variables. They are not constants. So omega naught is a constant. Okay. Assume sigma A square is equal to sigma B square. Assume sigma A square is equal to, that is, variances of the two random variables is same. Find Rxy of t1 comma t2 Ryx of t1 comma t2 and Rx of t and y of t WSS. Find whether both the random processes are voids and stationary or not. Here I add one more term. So jointly voids and stationary, or x of t and y of t jointly voids and stationary. So first evaluate Rxy of t1 comma t2, which is equivalent to expectation of x of t1, so y of t2, which is equivalent to expectation of, we write down the first one, a cos omega naught t1 plus b sine omega naught t2 T1 close this, so multiplied with A sine omega naught T2 minus B cos omega naught T2. You close this. So what you will get? Expectation of a square into expectation of the cos omega naught t1, omega naught t2. That can be taken out. Is it right? This is cos omega naught t1 sine omega naught t2. That is one term minus b square. Is it? Into sine omega naught t1 into cos omega naught t2. Two more terms are there. So expectation of AB so multiplied with cos omega naught t1 cos omega naught t2. Is it right? But expectation of AB is 0. So therefore the term is 0. And next one is expectation of AB sin omega naught t2 omega naught t1. That term is also 0 because expectation of AB is given as 0. Therefore, we have only these two terms. The other two terms are 0. See here, it is given that expectation of A is 0 and expectation of B is also 0. So if the expectation of A and B is 0, then whatever the mean square value if this is 0, expectation of A square is equal to sigma a square. Is it? See, variance is equal to difference between mean square value and square of the mean value. So here mean value is 0. Square of the mean value is also 0. So therefore, the variance is equal to mean square value. So therefore, expectation of a square is equal to sigma a square. And expectation of b square is also equal to sigma b square. But we already know that expectation of a square is equivalent to expectation of b square. Is it? So therefore, here expectation of a square is equivalent to expectation of b square. That can be taken, which is equivalent to sigma a square. So therefore, I can write it as expectation of a square multiplied with cos omega naught t1 sin omega naught t2 sin omega naught t1 cos omega naught t2. This is cos A sin B minus sin A cos B. This is sin is it right? See, it is already given that the two random variables are of zero mean. And their variance is same. That implies when the mean is 0, variance is equal to mean square value. So therefore, expectation of a square is equal to expectation of b square, that is equal to sigma a square. Understood this? Now if you let the difference t2 minus t1 is equal to tau, that is the time lag between the two times is tau, then this can be written as sigma a square sine omega naught tau. So this can be written as now rxy of tau. So what this indicates, see they are of zero mean, the two crosses are of zero mean and the cross correlation is the function of the time lag. So therefore the process is said to be jointly wide sense stationary. you find this also. So what will be the ryx of tau? You find ryx of tau. So this will be equivalent to minus of rxy of tau equivalent to ryx of minus tau. That is one kind of symmetry, is it? See here, rxy of tau is not even. Rxy of tau is not even. But if you consider the autocorrelation rxx, ryy, they are even functions of. But here it is the cross correlation. So it satisfies a special kind of symmetry, that is rxy of tau is equivalent to ryx of minus tau. So we already know this rxy of tau. Find this ryx of tau. So now we see the classification of random process. So we already know the one classification based on the determinism of the sample functions. The sample functions of the random process are deterministic, and the process is said to be deterministic random process. Otherwise, it is a non-deterministic random process. So based on that, we have one class of random process, that is deterministic and non-deterministic random process. And another classification is based on the statistical properties. If the statistical properties of the process are not varying with time, then the process is said to be a stationary random process. Otherwise, it is a non-stationary random process. Therefore, we have stationary and non-stationary random process. Here, this classification is based on the statistical properties. If the statistical properties of the random process are not varying with time, then the process is said to be stationary random process. Otherwise, it is a non-stationary random process. And then we have, based on the time averages and ensemble averages, another classification. So ergodic random process, non-ergodic random process. A random process is said to be ergodic if the ensemble averages are equivalent to time averages. Otherwise, it is a non-ergodic process. So here, this is the basic classification of the random process into three different types: deterministic, non-deterministic, stationary and non-stationary. Here something is missing, I think. STATL. Ergodic and non-ergodic random process. And in this case, based on the stationarity, that is based on the order of the statistical measures, we have first order stationary random process, second order stationary random process, and nth order stationary random process. So later we see second order stationarity and nth order stationarity. So based on the statistical measures that we consider, that is based on the mean, autocorrelation, we have different type of stationarity, that is the first order stationarity, second order stationarity and nth order stationarity. So in this context, we study the WSS random process also. That is wide sense stationary random process. What is the meaning of this WSS random process? Wide sense stationary random process. The first thing we already know, okay, the sample functions are deterministic, then the process is said to be deterministic random process, otherwise it is a non-deterministic random process. See, this classification is based on the statistical properties, and there is another classification. So based on that, you can classify into continuous random process discrete random process continuous random sequence discrete random sequence. So this is another way of classification.